Hi, it's Lee Krumholtz, and I'm standing in front of Cincinnati's architectural gem, the Art Deco building right behind me called the Cincinnati Union Terminal. Cincinnati's Union Terminal once was a train station, and now it is the home of the Cincinnati Museum Center. It's too cold out here, so I'm going to head inside.
Senior Registrar for Cincinnati Museum Center. My role is really working with lenders who will loan us objects, such as yourself, which we're very grateful for, and then working with the traveling exhibit folks on installing the artifacts within the larger exhibit. So the gold exhibit is two components. There's the big 10,000 square foot exhibit from the American Museum of Natural History, which has been traveling for about 4 years now, and it's got some spectacular pieces in it. Things from sunken treasures and rocks and ore and the like, as well as lots of worked gold and gold coins. So it's really pretty spectacular. And then we have added our own local component, Queen City Gold, out of the vault. It's sort of the two-part name to it. And that includes certainly the local gold jewelry that we got from you. We've got a wonderful Kentucky Derby trophy from 1970. We've got a Laconia, which is Turfway Park now, a trophy from 1927. We have Olympic gold medals. Local swimmer Jenny Kemp, who won the 1972 gold medal for swimming, which was also the last year that the medals were actually 22 karat gold. And so it's a gorgeous piece. And then we have some historic pieces. From our own collection, we have the large teapot, which people have seen here before. We've got a number of other pieces of our Hubbard medals from the 1924 Olympics, as well as Jacob Strader and General Findlay, I believe it is, more lines of beer collection material. So it's quite a great exhibit. It's going to be opening to the public on February 6th and closing May 16th.